Thank you, guys. It's really great to be here today to talk about some really interesting topics, and I can see definitely the passion in the room today. So today I'm going to talk to you about the art and science of how we truly become customer-centric. Greg talks a lot this morning about the context that we're all in, around how we understand customer expectations are really high, and I think we'll all understand what we need to do to really become high performers in our day-to-day job, but also give our customers the experience that they need. So my journey to customer-centric marketing began about a decade ago, and Jeremy will remember this, when I was at Caesars Entertainment, and that's when I implemented Salesforce. And that's when I truly saw how companies can start to connect to their customers with the power of Salesforce. And since then, in 2015, I took the plunge, I went on the other side, the dark side, and I joined Salesforce. And since then, I probably say I have the dream job where I consult with incredible brands across the globe on their customer experience visions, how they arrive at digital transformation. And my day-to-day is running workshops with lots of customers, with loads of post-it notes on the wall, really thinking about their customer journeys. Now, having worked in customer experience for some time and being an absolute enthusiast of it, everyone knows me, knows how many screenshots I send of really good customer experiences, I'm often asked, Sally, who's doing it well? And when I ask that, I stop and I look at my phone. And the reason I do that is because arguably, our phones are the nearest and dearest things to us. And if I was a brand or a company, I would want to appear on the first home screen of someone's phone, not in a folder. Not the second, not the third, and by no means the fourth, where all our redundant apps potentially sit that we can't delete. Now, when I break it down, I look at the apps that I have on my home screen, and by no means was this planned. Spotify is one of them, along with others, which I'll talk to you about why in just a moment. Spotify is a music provider of my choice, and I'm actually a premium customer, not a subscription one. The reason why is because they listen to what I'm listening to on a daily basis. I have the Discovery Weekly playlist. I listen to podcasts, and then I'm recommended the next best podcast to listen to. And when we're also short of time, things like this become a really good customer experience, and we start building loyalty with brands like this. Never have I received a promotion, a coupon, or a refer-a-friend link from Spotify, but yet I hold so many Apple devices in my household, and I'm often sent Apple Music emails for free trials, and I still don't subscribe. When my friends send me recommendations for songs to listen to, they send it via Apple Music. I still manually type in Spotify what I want to listen to. And for me, that customer experience is a positive outcome of their great customer experience they provide. Netflix. Netflix for me is great because they were the ones that really started to show and define what omnichannel really means. If you think about when you watch Netflix on your TV, your laptop, the multiple devices we all hold, we're able to connect and pick up the last episode of what we watched in the next device. So for me, it's great. When I'm watching Mad Men, I don't need to go back on my laptop and scroll through 8 seasons of it to get to the episode that I want. I can pick up where I last left off. Yes, there's other providers like Hulu, etc. out there. But again, it's the positive customer experience I get from these guys that makes me loyal to their brand and so forth. And Uber. How many of us here use Uber? But in actual fact, we know there's cheaper taxi companies out there, and it's quite controversial. But the customer experience Uber give me, if I'm traveling for work, I know I'm going to get an e-receipt that can go into my expense report. If I leave my phone in a taxi, which I did the couple of days, I know I'm going to get my phone back. And it's experiences like this and the technology that they provided us makes us pick these people. Because when Uber's surging at 2.5, we still get at Ubers. Realistically, we can get on a black taxi and get a black taxi, and it'll probably be cheaper. So the way I like to think about it is customer loyalty is an outcome to positive customer experience. It's not about what you give them based on value. Now, we all are here today because we've seen unprecedented change in technology. We've seen how technology has changed our everyday lives. And we all need to adapt and make a change. And to put that into perspective, I want to play you a little clip.
Hey, hey! Let's hear it for revolutions. Because they bring change. They move the human race forward. Revolutions happen when a group of people see an empty space that needs filling, a wrong that needs righting, and a chance to rewrite the future. Well, there's a revolution happening right now, today. It's the fourth industrial revolution. And it's changing everything. Technology is changing. Everything and everyone is connected, all the time, everywhere. Business is changing. It's becoming the platform for change, where companies do well by doing good. Work is changing, with new skills, new demands, and new opportunities for all. And with all that change, people are changing. Getting empowered, inspiring others, and blazing new trails. Salesforce is for trailblazers. People who look right past the status quo, see what ought to be, and then build it. For 20 years, Salesforce has focused on one simple, most important thing: customer success. Helping every company connect with their customers in a whole new way. Trailblazers know for each of us to succeed, we all have to succeed together. Learn the skills of the future together and create a better world together. And together, we'll define this revolution and discover the trailblazer in all of us.
What we do is we bring customers and companies together and try and unite them around anything around marketing, service, IT, all in the bid to drive better customer experiences. Now, whether you're in manufacturing, we help manufacturers connect to their customers in a whole new way. Whether you're in financial services, we help bring financial services customers together with their most loyal customers as well. Why? Because customer experience is more important than ever. We know that 80% of customers will actually believe that customer experience a company provides is just as important as products and services. How many of us here today have actually engaged or transacted with the company based on their customer experience, let alone their products and services? I know we all have. And here's why. Here's a recent story where I was coming back from my holiday, and before I went out, the shampoo and conditioner that I ordered for my holiday hadn't arrived in time, 24 hours before my trip. I tracked the item, apparently it's arrived, but it hasn't. So I go straight into the Amazon app, I go to help section, and Amazon proactively and predictively served me the picture of the last item I ordered. And yes, Amazon sell really great Panama hats, if you didn't know, and I have an absolute hat fetish. So it wasn't that particular item that I inquired about. So just through a few buttons, I was able to tell them what item that I'm inquiring about. I didn't have to leave the app. I didn't have to go into an email and find my order number and explain what I'm trying to do. They were leading the service. They were leading the conversation. So within 59 seconds, and I was timing it because I knew this would be an awesome story for a session like this one day, I was able to get the item back out shipped to me. And within that, it was solved. And it's where we're seeing the role of artificial intelligence really having a role in the way that we are engaging with customers, and some of the expectations that are being satisfied by us are through these technologies that we're seeing today. Another example is with the Adidas. Has anyone here actually shopped from the Adidas app or the Adidas website? Well, Adidas have done really well, and this is actual screen grab from 2.5 years ago. This is something they presented at Dreamforce in 2017. And it's reasons why this is why customer expectations are so high. Because Amazon and Adidas are driving that customer experience up here. So effectively, if people are shopping for the first time, this is the expectation that they're expecting. But also, this is why you become a provider of choice, like the apps I downloaded on my first screen. Now, what Adidas can do is have the ability to have that centralized view of as a customer. So if you're engaging in commerce, or if I open Facebook Messenger, they know what I'm potentially inquiring about. And they think about breaking down those channels, because as customers, we don't think in departments. We don't think about silos. We think about one brand. And it's that one-to-one experience that we all want to drive. Their commitment to customer experience is really impressive. This is a slide they allowed me to share with you today around what they're doing. And again, this was a slide that they developed internally 2.5 years ago. They know that to do customer service really well, they need to be omnichannel. They don't want their architecture, systems, silos, teams, business processes to get in the way they do business with their customers and drive those direct relationships. But when we're in our day-to-day world and we see the CMOs or you're a CDO and you know really thinking about growth, everyone's building more and more capabilities to do this and thinking about these steps that they're taking. But what we're doing is creating more silos. We're creating more fragmentation in what we're doing, and we're only adding to the problem. So what we need to really think about is how we continue to work really hard, because everyone works really hard in what they're doing with their own set of KPIs. They have their own data on their customer. But we need to bring everyone together and unite them with the lens of artificial intelligence, because we are better together. Your customer doesn't get an email or speak to your service center and think, oh, I'm on the phone to the service team or that's the CRM team. They think of you as one brand. And the minute we start uniting teams together, that's the biggest transformation and step change we need to make to align together, to share data, to build our data model so we have a centralized view of our customer. And when you're thinking about how do you actually apply this in your day-to-day? The state of play is that we are in a switch-driven marketplace. Customers will switch to another brand or company if you don't anticipate their needs. We know the number of average channels is only increasing. Last year when I was here, that stat was actually 5. It's now 10. So the number of channels is only increasing as well. More and more data is being created. If we think about voice search and IoT of things, the amount of data that's being created is unprecedented, and it's only going to continue. The amount of data sources is led to go up to 45 by 2020, which is huge. So when you're all in your offices and your day-to-day or in some of my sessions and you're running journey mapping workshops, when you're thinking about your customer experience, you need to think about your end-to-end customer experience all across the life cycle. And it's one thing to move from a campaign mindset to a journey mindset. But the reality is when you're thinking about your customer experiences, as John Legend rightly said, life is what happens when you're busy making plans. When we're at work, we can think about this perfect journey that our customers want to go to, but our journeys aren't linear as they may feel. There are twists, there are turns in every single customer journey. Gone are the days where we opened an email and converted off the back of it and reported on that particular call to action button. And this is why we need to be customer centric. We are all customers, we're all humans, and we know when we potentially book a holiday, we all go through similar paths like this. And this is where technology really starts to be an enabler for you. The biggest step change is how you think about becoming customer centric. The technology is really there as a tool to provide you what you need to do for your customers. Now, to bring this into a little bit of context, I'm not going to go into product too much, but I just want to show you how we're starting to answer those questions with real-time interaction management. So when we look at the customer lifecycle stages from awareness, reach, consideration, purchase, you start seeing where your customers are actually going in the customer journey. You start studying that unhappy path that they're going down, and we're able to orchestrate this across all the channels so we can be channel-less, if that's even a word, in what we're doing. Because that's effectively what our customers need. We've even seen ATMs plugged in to this. So financial services companies are able to have that omnichannel view across their customers as well. Now, I'm going to play you a short clip, and this was by no means planned with this morning's presentations. I've probably given it away. Now, this is a company that has the mission to become customer-centric, really at the heart of what they're doing. They don't have a CDO, a CIO. They don't have a typical board meeting room in an office somewhere. But what they want is to connect to their fans.
Mm-hmm. hard to stand still when that plays. Okay, so Metallica. Any surprises there? So Metallica, as you all know, they've been touring since 1982. That's before I was even born. Now, they've been touring 50 shows a year for the last 5 years in a row with Live Nation, doing incredible jobs and really connecting to their fans in those moments. But they know that they can't tour forever. They're in their 60s. But what they want to do is continue their legacy. They know the magic, from what we've seen earlier from Rack and Jeremy, the magic doesn't just happen in the concert at the time. It happens in the lead up when you're getting excited, knowing that they're announcing their tour date. It happens when you're in your lead up to go to the event, when you're in your event, and then post event. How can you relive that experience again, talk about it with your friends, and experience that? And Lars Ulrich said it the best. Yeah, he's the drummer and he's the co-founder of Metallica. And he says, music to me is connecting people and sharing experiences together. We all can agree that music brings everybody together, which is why we all love it so much. And they see technology as a way of bridging the divide between them and their fans and bringing them closer together. Before this project started, they had 500,000 subscribers that they were engaging with. By becoming customer-centric, in a short couple of months, it went up to 1 million. And that's just from a digital marketing perspective. That's not taking into the fact the 6 million people they have on their social media channels. So they've become customer-centric, and the way they're continuing this further down the line is how they reimagine this and report back and really live and breathe this in their organization as being customer-centric. This is an example of their dashboard that's cross-channel. I know all of us today probably report well, but we probably report on our own KPIs, not the customer KPIs, and what does customer-centric KPIs look like. So they're able to see the amount of tickets that are being sold all over the world. They're able to see engagement. They're able to see tickets. If we think about a traditional business, this might be e-commerce KPIs. This might be social KPIs. This might be CRM KPIs. But they don't think about it like that. They think about it towards, what are we doing to connect to our fans better? They're able to see their social media posts. They're able to see things at a regional level to see how many ticket sales are going on. They've been able to see the live streams per month. So this is like a group level dashboard they have, and they're just carrying this through. They're carrying this through if they're doing their world tour. They're even carrying this through when they're doing their Black and Whiskey campaigns and so forth. And this is how this starts to become an enabler. The technology's there. It's how, to Jeremy and Rack's point earlier, how do you think differently? How do you make a bold move and just think differently and not wait for the case study in your industry to come out? Because it's all about making that change and making that risk and also not thinking about what you're doing, what someone else is doing in your industry. It's about what does your brand believe and what do you want to do with your customers and allowing technology and the people to come together and make that reality. So I'll leave you with that. I hope that's been insightful, and I'm around for any questions.